All right, imagine this. You wake up one morning, stretch, look out the window, and notice something off. The sky is a perfect, uninterrupted blue, no clouds, not even a tiny wisp of one. You step outside, and the sun feels different. The air feels different. Everything feels wrong. And then it hits you. There are no clouds anywhere on Earth. Not a single fluffy cumulus. Not a dramatic storm front. Not even that weird, flat layer of stratus clouds that makes the sky look like an old Windows XP wallpaper. Just nothing. At first, you might think, oh, cool. No more gloomy, overcast days. No more unexpected downpours ruining my plans. But hold on. Clouds aren't just big, puffy sky decorations. They play a massive role in Earth's climate, weather, and, well, life itself. So, if every cloud on Earth suddenly vanished overnight, what would actually happen? Stage 1. Instant weather chaos. Let's start with the obvious. No clouds equals no rain. Without clouds, the entire planet becomes a giant, drying sponge. Rivers start shrinking. Crops don't get the water they need. Forests, especially rainforests, turn into sad, crispy fire hazards. And if you're thinking, well, we still have lakes and oceans. Yeah, sure. But without clouds, evaporation goes into overdrive, and there's nothing to hold that moisture in the air. Normally, evaporated water condenses into clouds, which eventually fall as rain. But now, that water just vanishes into the atmosphere, never to return. Deserts? Oh, they love this. The Sahara, the Atacama, Death Valley, these places already get very little rain, and now they get zero. Goodbye, cacti. Meanwhile, places that depend on regular rainfall, like India during monsoon season or the Amazon rainforest, are absolutely screwed. No monsoons. No replenishing downpours. Just drought on a level we've never seen before. But wait, it gets worse. Stage 2. Temperature madness. Clouds are Earth's natural thermostat. They reflect sunlight during the day, keeping things cool, and they trap heat at night, keeping things warm. Without them, temperature swings go wild. Daytime? Boiling hot. With no clouds to reflect sunlight, the planet absorbs way more heat. Deserts become even more uninhabitable. Cities turn into concrete frying pans. Nighttime? Freezing cold. Without clouds to trap heat, all that warmth radiates straight into space. Even in normally mild areas, temperatures plummet at night. The result? A planet that's basically playing hot potato with extreme weather. Think of it like this. Clouds are like a cozy blanket for the Earth. Without them, we're completely exposed to space. And space does not care about your comfort. Stage 3. The oceans freak out. Okay, let's check in on the oceans. How are they doing? Short answer, not great. Clouds are a key part of Earth's water cycle, helping to distribute heat and regulate ocean temperatures. Without them, things get super weird. First, warm tropical waters overheat because, again, no clouds equals no sun protection. That heat builds up, fueling stronger hurricanes, typhoons, and cyclones. These storms would still form over the oceans, but they wouldn't have cloud cover to balance things out. Expect hyper-intense storms that don't just mess up coastal cities. They wipe them off the map. Meanwhile, polar oceans start freezing harder than ever because they're losing heat like crazy at night. So now we have superstorms near the equator and deeper freezes at the poles. Basically, the whole climate system is in full meltdown mode. And let's not forget something even worse. Ocean life depends on a stable temperature. Mess with that, and suddenly fish populations start crashing. Coral reefs? Bleached beyond saving. Food chains? Falling apart. Oh, and goodbye sushi. Stage 4, mass extinctions begin. If we somehow survive the immediate chaos, let's talk about the long-term effects. Because no clouds equals no rainforests. No rainforests equals no oxygen production. Yes, the ocean produces a lot of Earth's oxygen, but rainforests, especially the Amazon, are key players in keeping the atmosphere balanced. Without them, oxygen levels start dropping. Not overnight, but over decades, leading to massive ecosystem collapses. Meanwhile, without rain, farmland turns to dust. Crops fail. Food supplies dwindle. Famine spreads. And don't even get me started on wildfires, because if you think things are bad now, imagine a world where everything is bone dry all the time. Stage 5, humanity's last stand. So, what's the end game here? Could we adapt? Could we find a way to survive in a world without clouds? Maybe, but it would be brutal. We'd have to rely on artificial irrigation for farming, if we could even find enough water. Coastal cities would have to move inland because of supercharged storms. We'd need massive climate engineering projects like giant floating sunshades in the sky to mimic what clouds used to do naturally. And even if we figured all that out, we'd be living in a world where the environment is constantly trying to kill us. Not exactly the future we were hoping for, huh? So what have we learned today? Clouds might seem like fluffy, innocent background scenery, but they're absolutely vital to life on Earth. They control our weather, protect us from extreme temperatures, and keep the water cycle running. Without them, Earth turns into a chaotic, scorching, freezing, drought-ridden, hurricane-fueled nightmare. So the next time you complain about an overcast day, maybe just say thank you to the clouds, because trust me, you do not want to know what happens when they're gone. If you enjoyed this wild thought experiment, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next deep dive into absurd science. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.